गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज हार्मोनल कंट्रोल ऑफ स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस। सो स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस दैट इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्पर्म, फंक्शनल स्पर्म, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ फंक्शनल स्पर्म फ्रॉम नॉन मोटाइल स्पर्मेटिड, नॉन मोटाइल स्पर्मेटिड, दिस वन इज नोन एज स्पर्मेटोजेनेसिस। सो which hormones that are responsible for the spermatogenesis? So firstly, hypothalamus, that is a part of forebrain, that is a part of forebrain. It releases gonadotropin releasing hormone and gonadotropin inhibiting hormone. These hormones act on the anterior pituitary, and from the anterior pituitary two hormones are released, LH luteinizing hormone, but in case of male this one is also known as interstitial cell stimulating hormone, and second one is the FSH. The receptor for these hormones are present on the leading cells. For the LH, these are present on the leading cells, and for the leading cells, or also known as interstitial cell. For the FSH, receptor are present on the Sertoli cells. The function of these leading cells, these help in the secretion of androgen. Androgen, these are the steroid hormone, and in under the androgen different hormones are present. One of them is testosterone, dihydroepiandrosterone, and lots of other androgens are present under this category. So leading cells help in the secretion of this testosterone. Function of this testosterone, these help in the secondary sexual character formation. Etc. And these Sertoli cells secret inhibin. This inhibin is a proteinaceous hormone, and this proteinaceous hormone make a negative feedback effect on the FSH. So this one is a hormonal control for the spermatogenesis, and these two, LH and FSH, these are known as gonadotropin hormone. Why these are known as gonadotropin hormone? Because these gonadotropin hormone act on the gonads, Sertoli cells, that is a part of testes. That's why these are known as gonadotropin hormone. This one is all about the hormonal control of spermatogenesis. Now there are two types of sperm. As you know, in the most of animal, male containing X and Y. At the time of meiosis, when these X, Y separated, just like this, X and Y. At the time of fertilization, when this X from the male carry X from the female, so 50% of chances this one, and this again female X combined with male Y. तो 50-50% chances होते हैं यहाँ पे। 50% chances जो होते हैं उसमें क्या होते हैं, gynosperm formation, and 50 होता है endosperm formation. So these are gyne or endosperm formation take place. So 50% chances होते हैं यहाँ पे for this, and 50% for this. So these are two type of sperm, that is mainly known as gynosperm or endosperm. Now we are going for the structure of spermatozoa or sperm, functional sperm. As you know, different parts. First is known as head region, second neck, third part होता है इसे यहाँ पे होता है middle piece, and last one is known as tail region, fourth one is tail. Firstly head region, head comprises acrosome and this one nucleus. Clear? Acrosome, this acrosome containing lots of hydrolytic enzymes, hydrolases. Example, कौन कौन से hydrolases होते हैं यहाँ पे, hyaluronidase, jonalysine, cathepsin, binding at crossing. So these are different hydrolases or proteolytic enzymes which help in the penetration in the egg during the fertilization. So each part having their specific function in this sperm or spermatozoa. So acrosome containing many hydrolases enzyme which are responsible for the penetration inside the sperm. Second one is the nucleus. Nucleus containing genetic information. Contains chromatin, fibers, RNA, inactive form, and this condensed chromatin DNA is packed within the histone protein, and many histone protein are changed or replaced by the protamines. So this one is the nucleus that contains the genetic information. Just below the nucleus, in this depression, there is a centriole present that is known as proximal centriole. What is the function of this proximal centriole? Help in the first cleavage. जैकम जो फर्स्ट क्लीवेज होगा उसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल होगा प्रोक्सिमल. हियर सेकंड वन इज प्रेजेंट जस्ट बिहाइंड द प्रोक्सिमल दैट इज नोन एज डिस्टल सेंट्रियोल. द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस डिस्टल सेंट्रियोल इज हेल्प इन द एक्सियल फिलामेंट फॉर्मेशन. दिस वन इज द एक्सियल फिलामेंट. सो दिस वन इज द हेड रीजन. दिस शॉर्टर इज द नेक. This region is known as middle piece. This middle piece contains spiral mitochondria that are known as Nabenkern. These mitochondria is known as Nabenkern, and the layer that surround this middle piece and the posterior half of this nucleus is known as Mankette or Manchette. Is other layer that surround the anterior part of chromosome, acrosome and nucleus that is known as galia. This is the middle piece that is containing the loads of spiral form of mitochondria. That's why this one is known as powerhouse, which provide energy. And this last portion is known as tail region. Here microtubule and the cytoplasmic sheet is present, that is exoneme. So this one is a complete structure of a functional sperm that is formed by the process of spermatogenesis. Firstly, hybridization comprises this acrosome and the nucleus. So both acrosome and nucleus, these are the important part and containing almost all the enzymes which are responsible for the fertilization. Second one is the neck region. This neck region containing the centrioles, and the function of the centrioles is help in the first cleavage. This one is a mitochondria. Spiral form of mitochondria is known as Nabenkern, and the other layer that surround the posterior half of the nucleus, and this middle piece is known as Manchette, and last this portion is known as the tail region. Tail region that giving the lashing movement. Lashing movement. During copulation inside the female genital tract. So this is the complete structure of the sperm. Thank you.